Welcome to the Mind Health Coach Program with Leah Marie here on the Dream Vision 7 Radio Network. You can learn more about Leah's coaching services at mindhealthcoach.com. Thank you for joining us today as we journey into the discovery of natural and healthy ways to achieve inner peace, happiness, and an ever-present state of well-being. You're already healed. You just haven't realized it yet. When you're ready, you can change your mind and change your life forever. The power of a beautiful life is within you today.
Welcome to the Mind Health Coach Program. I'm Leah Marie, your host. You're listening to a Dream Vision 7 Radio Network broadcast here, and we're heard every Friday at 10 a.m. and 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. To learn more and for a full station broadcast schedule, go to dreamvision7radio.com. You can also learn more about the Mind Health Coach Program and the programs that I offer at www.mindhealthcoach.com. I actually, also have another website that you can visit to learn more in-depth information about mooditations. It's my meditation program it's a daily meditation program for overall well-being and helping you heal, also helping you focus and helping you co-create. And I'm, thinking that this is a good show to talk about co-creation and setting intentions and, working towards that aspect for 2019. It is the solstice is happening, winter solstice is happening. We have a full moon that's going to be coming up, and I know that that's probably going to be old news when you guys hear the show repeated, but right now in this week of Christmas is when we're recording the show. And so I'm taking the energy that is available at this time to talk about, what experiences you can have. And I'm aware, like one of my mentors that I love, she's been around for many years, and she also is a very incredible meditation teacher. I go to her class monthly, had talked about the class that I attended this month. The energy that comes in on the 21st through the 28th is a very high energy. And it's amazing what you can do with this energy, because the way she speaks about it is that you are able to really transform things in your life at this time. It's open and available to you to do with utilizing this energy that's coming in from December 21st through December 28th. And it's just going to come in, and it's going to ride over the universe, and it's going to come right over Earth, and all beings that are in the right state of consciousness can access this amazing, powerful, power-boosting energy. So it's kind of a really good time to make sure that your chakras are clear on all levels. It's great to really focus and meditate during this time, but also allowing any of the drama that's happening or any traumas that's happening around you, just kind of to step aside from that, not allow yourself to be too attached. And I heard another teaching session that I was listening to the other day about that there is this, the whole concept of a mandala is about creating the mandala and then this beautiful, intricate design that you create in the sand. And then you actually just, at the end of maybe days of working on this mandala, you actually just, swipe it and erase it, because you're showing that even though it's so beautiful and you work so hard on it, that you're detached from it. And it helps you look at things a little differently, because it's true. Like, you think about all the beauty that happens during spring, the beautiful flowers, the gardens that we plant, and, every year, the beauty that comes out of the ground and the earth at that time of year. And then what happens? We go through summer, things start getting drier. Then in the fall, things start getting browner. And by the time that winter's here, which is right now, everything's gone. We have to be detached from whatever plants and beauty that was happening in nature during those months that were happening from spring through summer. And with expectation that there's new growth in the spring again. So it's that's basically what I'm kind of guessing is the lesson from our seasons and our changes that we have frequently throughout the year. Now, I know some parts of the world do not have much vegetation change, but I'm located in America in an area that there are four seasons, so I get to experience that sense of, okay, I can't wait for spring. I get to see this. I plant things. I work on my garden. I work on it all summer long to really create this beautiful, wonderful experience with nature that I'm just in harmony with and I enjoy so frequently. I touch it, you know, every day when I walk outside of my house. I see the flowers I planted and the way that I shaped my gardens, and I feel a sense of inner peace and knowing that I co-created with Mother Earth. And at that time, you're really in appreciation and in gratitude. And I meditate out near my gardens. I love sitting next to the gardens. And I have a Buddha statue where I always love to place petals in his hands, which are usually they're cupped in, you know, a stance of a mudra that's kind of for meditation. And I'll sit and I'll meditate with my Buddha statue and flowers in his cupped hands. And, you know, I always feel like miracles happen at that time. I just feel like it's like amazing that, okay, I co-created, I meditated making this garden happen in conjunction with the energy of Mother Earth and, you know, the universe. And now I'm sitting here, I'm really kind of in communion with a ascended master that I really appreciate, and just sensing that energy, that higher consciousness that just brings us into a space where it's inner peace and knowing that it's all, you know, a blessing and such gratitude. And I just find that after that, I start seeing this like kind of synchronicity of other miracles and gifts happening. When I really get mindful about that type of experience, I tend to then notice those things that transpire around us that aren't, you know, that aren't, sometimes they go unnoticed. Sometimes they're just like things that pass by and I don't even realize, oh gosh, you know, I should have recognized that happened. And, you know, it's powerful when you do. And it really can change a moment for you. It can make you feel empowered and supported. And so, and then ultimately in a full state of gratitude with inner peace. And with that being said, you know, it kind of relates really well to the mandala and the practice of the mandala and how you're creating this beauty in the moment, and it's kind of a meditative trance you're in when you're doing it. And then for the detachment, you're just erasing it. And it's kind of, you know, a really extraordinary experience that you work through a lot of pieces in your path that maybe you needed to work on to improve your soul's growth. And, you know, I think that there's a lot of opportunities and availabilities for us to do that in our own lives without actually drawing a mandala. Like I mentioned, doing the gardening or, you know, just doing work that suits you, who you are, what your personality is, what makes you light up. Because we're all different. We all have our own opinions and we've all had our own life experiences that, you know, have molded us to our perceptions. But, you know, I think all of us ultimately have this goal in our lives to achieve that inner peace and gratitude state. And if you haven't got there yet where you want to achieve that and you're more in the aspect of, you know, you want to get ahead, you want to make more money or have more materialistic items, then it may be something that you should think about. I'm not saying that in a statement of judgment, but that all can go away, and then what are you left with? You're still going to be wondering what you need to achieve in life, because most of us are in that space of wanting growth. That's why we're here. We're here to create. It's really important to recognize that we've been given this huge gift of being able to be in a state of creation. And, you know, it's really co-creating, because you're kind of playing out that experience. That you're here for a reason. Everybody has their own purpose. And I feel very strongly from my own path that at different times in your life, there's different purposes. It's not like one purpose is just what it is. You know, for instance, I have two kids, and, you know, the purpose during the time that I was raising them and, you know, seeing them grow up to be women, it was really important for me to focus on being there for them and being in a space where I was mentoring and teaching. And I haven't left that role. They're not, you know, they're adult children, but they're not so on their own yet that, you know, they're kind of doing their own thing with their own kids. They haven't reached that state yet, but I'm still mentoring and guiding, but I have more time now in my life for looking at, okay, what's my next leg of this journey? Where do I grow from here? Not where do I go, where do I grow, you know? And I've really enjoyed some of the things I've been picking up recently because I had put some of those aspects on hold of my soul's growth, personally my soul's growth, and to have that opportunity again to really open up the door and look at different aspects that I can learn about and achieve a higher level of consciousness and then co-create even more than I already have. And, you know, I'm not saying I've done it all. I haven't. I have a lot of work to do. I have a lot of aspects of me that need to be worked through and worked out. I wouldn't be here if I didn't, you know. But I really take this opportunity and the teachings that I've been working with seriously at this point in my life for my own personal growth and how to achieve the purpose that I'm kind of seeing at this point. Like, you have to know what lights you up and what's of your true essence. And a couple things really intrigue me. Like, I am so fascinated by some of the things that are coming out to help preserve the planet. You know, I think that some of these younger folks are just so inspiring and amazing. I'm seeing, like, videos and people sharing, you know, and I really love this one that I saw, this one video that I saw regarding sustainability and eliminating plastic. And it was kind of funny because just the week before, I was thinking about plastic. And, you know, if we keep creating more plastic, we're seeing it building up in our oceans. You know, I'm getting things from my recycling company. You can't put this in recycling, you can't put that in recycling that I thought I was doing such a good job putting in the recycling bin. And now I'm understanding that it's just ending up in the ocean. And it's not just in our country, it's worldwide. As humans, we've become so reliant on plastic to do so much for us, you know, like medically. I had a medical issue this summer where I had Lyme disease and I had to have intravenous, I had a PICC line in my arm for a month, and I had to have intravenous antibiotics administered every day. And it was like, I could not believe the amount of plastic that we were going through because of all of these products that, you know, in order to keep things sanitary. And I just was like, this is such a waste, you know, meaning like, if I've got this one occurrence and there's so many people having medical issues all around the world, I can't imagine the plastic that's being built up from that. And, you know, I know it is really great for sanitary purposes and to help us with that, but there's got to be a different way. So I've been really intrigued by some of the stuff that I've seen out there. And one video in particular, like I mentioned, was really in line with what I was meditating on only days before, and that was, okay, well, you know, recycling isn't really doing it. It's not really, I mean, it helps somewhat, but what do we really need to do to preserve this planet? And one of the things I came up with was we need to stop producing plastic. You know, it really is critical at this point to look at plastic and say, okay, we need to put the brakes on plastic. And so at that point, I've been like kind of researching and looking for, you know, plastic-free products. And I learned about that. If you want to actually get a good product that is going to break down faster, biodegradable isn't really the way to go. It's actually compostable that you want to look for. So I am so impressed. I went out on the internet, which is a fabulous tool, and I did find these trash bags because I thought, geez, you know, I go through all these trash bags and, you know, I really am disgusted and